So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. And in today's session, guys, as usually, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed. And you can also follow me on Instagram. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, which international organization in collaboration with Asia Pacific Broadcasting Union? Now remember, Asia Pacific Broadcasting Union, it was established in the year 1964 and it is headquartered in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It is headquartered in Kuala Lumpur, which is of course in Malaysia. And Mr. Ibrahim Aaron is the current president of ABU, which is Asia Pacific Broadcasting Union. Under Together for Peace initiative has given an award to Doordarshan's program, which is known as Definitely Leading the Way in Peace Media Awards of 2021. Okay, so you have to identify which international organization has given this award to this Doordarshan's program. Okay, so let's talk about this news. So remember, this was ABU UNESCO Peace Media Prize 2021, and these awards have been recently held at Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, which is the headquarters of Asia Pacific Broadcasting Union. Now remember, the awards were given by UNESCO in collaboration, of course, with Asia Pacific Broadcasting Union under Together for Peace initiative. Do remember the name of this initiative, Together for Peace. And two awards were awarded to Indian organization. Number one, Doordarshan's program, which is Definitely Leading the Way under Living Well with Super Diversity category, and All India Radio's program Living on the Edge, the Coastal Lives, under Ethical and Sustainable Relationship with Nature category. So in these two categories, one award was given to Doordarshan and one award was given to All India Radio at Peace Media Awards 2021 under the theme Together for Peace initiative. Okay, so this was about this news, and therefore, guys, the correct answer is what, UNESCO. Now you have to tell me, where is the headquarter of UNESCO and who is the current chief of UNESCO? UNESCO ka headquarter comment mein likhke batao. Aur UNESCO ke abhi chief kaun hai wo batao. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. Minister of Science and Technology. And who is the minister, by the way? It's Dr. Jitendra Singh. Has launched India's first virtual science laboratory for children under CSIR Jigyasa program. Which IIT has partnered with CSIR in developing the lab? Remember, the CSIR Jigyasa program was launched in the year 2017 in collaboration with Kendra Vidyalaya Sangathan. And CSIR Jigyasa program is nothing but a student and scientist connect program to nurture the young minds. Jo students hai, unke young minds ko nurture karne ke liye, it is a student and scientist connect program which is being implemented by CSIR. And of course, CSIR president, ex-officio president, is the prime minister of country. Okay. Now let's talk about these labs. So Minister of Science and Technology has launched India's first virtual science laboratory for children under this program, which is CSIR Jigyasa program. And this is of course has been done to take science to every segment of the student in every corner of the country. Remember, this lab has been developed by CSIR, of course, in collaboration with IIT Bombay. IIT Bombay ne iske saath, CSIR ke saath collaborate kiya hai for developing this lab. Now the target students which will be covered under this program are from standard 6th to standard 12th, and initially the content is available in English, but later on the content will be developed in Hindi as well as regional languages. Alright, so this was about this news, and therefore, guys, IIT Bombay is the correct answer. IIT Bombay. Moving ahead to question number 3, which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to the awards given on World Fisheries Day 2021? So remember, World Fisheries Day is every day observed on 21st of November, and this year the celebration was held at Bhubaneswar. Bhubaneswar mein is saal ka celebration hua tha, and Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy Farming, Mr. Purushottam Rupala attended the celebration. And during this World Fisheries Day celebration, some awards were given, and these are the awards. Best Marine District was given to Balasore, which is in Odisha. Best Marine State Award was given to Andhra Pradesh. Best Inland State was Telangana. Best Inland District, Balaghat, Madhya Pradesh. Best Hilly and Northeastern State, it is Tripura. And Best Hilly and Northeastern District, it is Bongaigaon, which of course is in Assam. Okay, so these are the awards. So, zyada award nahi hai, so aapko yaad rakhe ja sakte hai. So, you should remember all these awards. So we have to identify incorrect statement out of these. So best marine state was Andhra Pradesh. Yes. Best inland state was Telangana. Correct. Best inland district was Balaghat MP. Yes, correct. Best hilly and northeastern state was given not to Arunachal Pradesh but to Tripura. So this statement is incorrect, which means option D guys is the correct answer. And abhi guys, is hafte jo sessions hain wo isi format mein rahenge. Because abhi I am not visiting office, I am not well. But don't worry, aapki classes miss nahi hongi, classes chalti rahengi. So don't worry about the classes. But yes, isi format mein rahega. Aaj ka video bhi aur Friday ka video bhi. Okay? मंडे से प्रॉपर जो भी हमारा मैं स्टूडियो में जिस तरीके से पढ़ाता हूँ उसी तरीके से चलेगा. आई बिलीव इसमें भी आप लोगों को कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होनी चाहिए. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. इन कोलैबोरेशन विद विच मिनिस्ट्री सीबीएसई हैज लॉन्च्ड अ सर्टिफिकेट कोर्स ऑन एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग फॉर द 21st सेंचुरी फॉर एजुकेटर्स. नाउ रिमेंबर दिस प्रोग्राम हैज बीन लॉन्च फॉर सीबीएसई स्कूल्स एंड एकलव्य मॉडल रेजिडेंशियल स्कूल. So now, can you identify the ministry? Because yes, I am talking about EMRS. So which means the correct answer should be Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Okay. And CBSE chairperson is who? Mr. Manoj Ahuja is the chairperson of CBSE. So let's talk about this news. So Ministry of Tribal Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Arjun Munda. His Lok Sabha constituency is Khunti. Khunti, of course, is in Jharkhand. And CBSE together have launched a certificate course on experiential learning for the 21st century for educators from CBSE and EMRS. Now this course will help teachers, school heads and principals. Remember, this is not only for teachers. This is for all teachers, this is for all school heads and this is for all principals to adapt classroom learning to real life experiences. Okay. And remember, this program has been launched in collaboration with various philanthropist organizations like Tata Trust, Center of Excellence in Teacher Education, CETE, TIS, which is Tata Institute of Social Sciences, and Mahatma Gandhi International School, which is located in Ahmedabad. Alright. This program has been deployed for 350 educators in 6 states. It will be, of course, a free of cost program. Some of the selected teachers will be recognized as teacher leaders by Ministry of Tribal Affairs, and these teacher leaders will support the EMRS teaching faculties, EMRS teaching fraternity across the country, across all the EMRS schools. Through whatever they have learned, they would learn from this program, from this initiative. Okay, जो भी वो सीखेंगे वो फिर बाकी ये हमारे इसके जो teachers हैं उनको वो सिखाएंगे. So therefore, guys, the correct answer should be what? Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Option D is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to last question for today. Question number 5. How many houses have been completed under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen as on 15th November 2021? So you must be wondering कि इतना factual question क्या पूछा जा सकता है? Yes, पूछा जा सकता है. Because this year in the month of November 2021, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen has completed 5 years of its implementation because it was launched in the year 2016. So the government gave the data regarding the number of houses completed as on 15th November 2021 on this occasion of completion of 5 years. Okay, and remember this scheme envisages the formation of 2.95 crore houses by the year 2022. And this information ki kitne ghar bane hai, how many houses have been completed, this information has been given by Awas Soft app hai ek. Us app ke through this information has been provided, and according to this information 1.63 crore houses have been completed under PMAYG as on 15th November 2021. And if you want to know about this scheme in detail, you can search on YouTube Anuj Jindal Government Scheme. There is a playlist of government scheme. If there, this scheme, you will get in too much detail. Okay. So therefore, guys, the correct answer is what? Option A, 1.63 crores. All right. So that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear and there were not enough news in PIB in the last 2-3 days. So that's why panchi question hai. And I'll see you on Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.